Hey, Jess, could you share your metaphysical perspective on too high levels of estrogen in the body causing fibroids and other symptoms? I've done my own research and have understanding, but would love to hear your opinion as it's always enlightening. Aya, I would love for you to ask that in quantum fitness too, if I know you're in there, I think. Anyways, let's talk estrogen. I mean, estrogen is a sex hormone, right? Designed to grow life, okay? It works with progesterone, it works with cortisol, it works with adrenaline, and it works with testosterone. It works with many other small, you know, not small, but other hormones that are not like mainstream to your nomenclature. So with the idea of what happens in a body with too much estrogen is just like if a woman was too much of a woman, like anything out of a balance appears insane. Truthfully, anything out of balance that is not balanced. Take a river. If a river is not balanced, it's out of control. If, you know, a volcano is not balanced, it's out of control, right? So again, you could take something that was in its true essence, divinely soft and nurturing and loving and creative and expansive and growing. And if you turn up the volume with that and create aggressive or you know, fire energy to it, you're going to get destruction. So this is kind of, in a very quick sense, the breakdown kind of quantum fitness, okay? So women come to me all the time, my hormones are messed up, my metabolism, my thyroid. No, your thoughts. So every thought produces 33,000 chemical reactions, every thought. Every chemical reaction has a reaction to that. So action creates reaction, cause, effect, right? Manifestation. You may not think that, thinking thoughts right now. And because you are so used to being over adrenalized, which means your stress response, fight, flight, freeze, is so common that you don't even necessarily experience your elevated heart rate anymore, although you're having it. You don't experience the shift in your nervous system unless something is acute or an emergency. You don't necessarily feel everything that's going on because although you are very sensitive to what is happening outside of you, you have become very insensitive to what is happening inside of you. So these things, these 911s, these check engine lights, these fires that are going off are not being seen and heard by us because we're believing that the feeling we're having is coming from the outside wobble. So I must stabilize the outside wobble so that I may feel better when technically I was supposed to tend to the wobble that was happening with me, but I'm so desensitized, I don't even notice that I'm cool, I'm fine, I'm chill, I'm good. Yeah, I got a solution for your problem. And we never really feel out of balance enough to pay attention to what we're feeling because it's not as safe for us to be tending to ourselves when our environments have become very dangerous, okay? So with that being said, when we have an overgrowth of anything going on in the body, whether it's too much testosterone, too much estrogen, too much adrenaline, too much cortisol, not enough serotonin, you know, a lack of producing of melatonin, then what we're experiencing is a imbalanced system. And this has been created by too prolonged fight, flight, or freeze, which means immunity has been running 24 hours. The army is like exhausted and I can't deal with the emotional, physical, and chemical results of your life. It's causing us to flatline. And then basically turn on itself. So estrogen will create what feels like a crazy train loop in a woman where if you can tell if a woman is too much estrogen is because she will be constantly damsel in distress, like 911, but will not actually hear when someone is giving them the solution. Right. So I used to work as a nutritionist with a lot of gals with POS, the polycystic fibrosis, which is an overgrowth of estrogen dominance. And that what creates those fibroids and cysts is the war of estrogen and testosterone, both steroids, both designed to work in harmony, but if they are in competition with each other, right, then what happens is they start to fight against each other. And now a growth hormone designed to create life, okay, like semen or what's in testosterone, the growth, like the chemical of growth, and then the space and expansion of the house, right, is now kind of like the house is on fire. And so estrogen, it's constantly like the battle of alignment, right? So it's like when one falls down, the other one gets more to pick it up. So it's like, think about it. A woman who doesn't feel safe, okay, is going to be in a constant state of fight or flight. Now, she may not know that because she's used to it, okay? But her brain and her body are not used to it. The way she reacts to her own needs is different. It's like someone who's always hungry, they're used to it. They don't even have the same feelings. Someone who's never hungry, right? So in this way, what happens is the woman, it becomes over adrenalized with cortisol. Cortisol is a fuel that fuels adrenaline to keep your energy and strength high. I call cortisol the instigator hormone because it works for and against us. Cortisol is the fuel that will fuel the adrenaline and keep it going. And cortisol is amazing at extracting sugars from other parts of the body to feed this adrenaline. And of course, that's going to come from organs, brains, hearts. It's going to strip magnesium, you know, potassiums. It's going to all the sugars that we could possibly manufacture. And because the body begins to die, estrogen, I'm going to grow everything, starts to get more and starts to grow bigger. And then testosterone's like, what are you doing, estrogen? You can't do this without me. If you're growing, I'm growing. So now there's this like competitive happening thing with our sex hormones. The adrenal glands are like, can't keep up. The thyroid's like, oh, great. Now you're bringing me into this. My job was to compose this orchestra, not to become the secondary adrenal gland, right? So now what happens is, my blood sugar is completely out of rhythm. My brain, body don't know what I want, need. I'm craving sugar. I actually need water. I'm not hydrating water because there's not enough enzymes in my mineral fluids to actually extract the water into my cells. So I'm just peeing around the clock. I'm feeling dehydrated. I'm feeling like a loony train, right? I am gaining weight, especially in my abdomen and around my hips and in my lymphatic drains, which is right here. Right here, below my belly button, between my thighs, on my outer hips and my outer arms. This is where you're going to see the results of too much estrogen being trying to be filtered through lymphatic and then grown out of proportion with testosterone that needs more energy because it's action-based to survive. So now you're exhausted. You're depressed, you're chubby, or at least bloated. Your organs are flatlining because they have very limited amounts of minerals to hydrate. Our breast tissue gets a little bit out of control, right? Because again, now everything that's designed to give life is going to grow. My belly, my breasts, right? Anything. And now because of the amount of estrogen, my body is saying, where's the baby? And now I'm depressed. Right. So then we try to lose weight and now we're trying to create loss when the body's trying to create life. So it is a very hard place for women to be at with who have polycystic fibrosis, because left alone to deal with either through synthetic estrogen to try to rebalance, which does help initially. Okay, when we give our bodies a synthetic to rebalance, it will balance temporarily. Okay, but the body ain't no dummy. So as soon as it starts to go, wait, this is the right formula, but I'm not having the right chemical compound here, it then starts to reject. And no doctor tells us that our bodies begin to reject it. And through the rejection process, our immunity has to fire up and it creates infertility. Okay. And now we're more susceptible to the cancers and things like that. Now, obviously, if we bring mind into this, if you're a woman, if you had estrogen dominance because of stress overload, guaranteed you felt like a loony train. You felt crazy. You were like, if anybody knew, they would lock me up. I cannot tell you how many times before I healed my eating disorder. Because, of course, when you're eating, you know, getting abandoned, getting rejected, getting abused, it's like you're in constant adrenal fatigue. And then trying to take care of kids and make it look like everything's okay and living a double life over here and trying to make ends meet. Or just trying to survive the day as a sensitive empath. It's like the overload is the body's going, okay, what can I do to help? You have to realize that we look so evilly at our own bodies, like, oh, how could you do this to me? But ultimately, your body is doing its best job to protect you. So if it doesn't feel safe, it's trying to grow protection for you. It's trying to house you, to create more of an invisibility, to try to slow you down. You think, well, no, I need to speed up. But that's usually what happens initially because, oh yeah, speed up, speed up, speed up. Now the way that I can survive is to slow my energy down and reserve it. So think about it. If I had a fight or flight like every 6 months, boy, that would increase my metabolism by 100%. But if I was in fight or flight every single day, all day, then my adrenal glands and everything would be like, okay, this is our life. You know, it's like the poor zebra. It's like, we're like out here 24/7 exposed. Like we don't know who's coming and going. So because the body has to stay in a heightened level of alert 24/7, then what it does is it reserves its energy. Okay. It'll take that piece of lettuce and it'll stretch out the chemical compounds and take every fiber of any sort of nutrition out of it to put into the reserves. So it's like rations. And this is what women always freak out. And they're like, why am I gaining weight? Like I'm eating less. Because when your environment is stressful, okay, when your environment is stressful, guys, your body goes on ration. Okay. It's like, what can I ration? What can I save? It's like the doomsday, go in the basement and have your toilet paper from COVID and where all your cans of fruits and vegetables are, right? That is what happens when your brain is in constant stress all the time. It goes from high metabolism, I can eat whatever I want and don't even have to work out, to all of a sudden you hit 30, 35 and you're like, what is this? You know? And now you're, or you've been overweight your whole life. It like, for me, it was like, I was born in a stress response. So my body was like, we need to reserve everything, you know, and you'll actually gain weight from losing, from eating less when your brain is in a 911. Okay. Because now it's a glitch. It's like trying to talk to a woman who is terrified. Like there's no, hello, there's no solution. Like, did you hear me? Take a breath. Like I'm right here. It's like a broken record. Because if you look at the definition of overgrowth of estrogen, it says the woman becomes in a loop mentality where she is literally like telling the same story over and over again, over and over again, over and over again, over and over again. This is what you're going to see the opposite effect in men, where they're constantly trying to find love through the seeding practice, right? This is the womanizer experience. This is the, you know, lots of different women to satisfy what they are lacking from their fight or flight. See, a man's fight or flight is not reserve my space and create ration. No. A man's aggressive fight, flight, or distress 911 overgrowth of that would become, I must seed. This is where our sex addictions come from. And this is where our, like, you know, kind of drug-induced relationships with men and women, where it's all based in instant gratification, not necessarily something substantial. Because for a man that's in this distress call because of overabundance of testosterone, he's got to put that somewhere. See, it's like a woman is like going to take her estrogen and like put it somewhere, you know, it's like on her body. A man's going to take his testosterone and put it on you. So it's literally like the same exact 911 call. And you can see that anytime anything gets out of balance, it becomes aberrated and it goes slightly insane, because when we have estrogen over dominance, we're going to have a depletion of magnesium. We're going to have a depletion of potassium. We're going to have a depletion of our like basic minerals and nutrients that we think we're getting from all those expensive supplements that are just washing right through you. Because the more estrogen dominant we are, or the more adrenalized we are, then the less we can actually grab nutrition, because we don't have the time. You realize the number one thing happens when you're in fight or flight, you've got to hear this, is your stomach stops digesting food. So you just spent, I get this all the time, and God love you if this is you, because I was here a thousand different times. You know, you finally, you get hope, you find relief, you find a new, you know, isogenics, or you find a new like Thrive product, right? And you're like, this is going to be my solution to my weight. And, you know, you go spend $180 on shakes, right? But you're in a stressful work environment. You're not being seen and heard in your relationship. You know, you've got that 20, 40 pounds sitting on you. You know, you're stressed out about money. So spending the money on the product is tough, but you're like going to do it. And you introduce all of it to your system and your body's like, oh, thank you. Yes, this is what we need, right? And you start to feel relief. You start to feel good. And then all of a sudden, because the stress environment does not change, then what happens is that, you know, 120 calorie shake starts to put weight on you, and the minerals and vitamins that your brain needs start to get run right through you. Because again, well, we've got an abundance of that, and we've got an abundance of that. We just get it through. We can't be heavy in and take up space. We've got to put our rations of fat. We've got to put rations in there. So let's strip out our amino acids that are keeping our muscles strong, because we don't need those. And let's utilize that for energy, and then store any of the yucky juju happening from the relationship fight in the fat cell. So what I saw a lot in my nutrition days was that, you know, when you are going on a calorie restriction diet, your body's like, I'll find it somewhere. I'll make it up. You know, I will literally take that lettuce and I will give you a chubby belly. And you're like, what? Right? Because it's your brain's ability to adapt and survive. And if there is toxic energy in your life, brain will think there's toxins in your body. So fat is the way we store a toxin, because all toxins are fat soluble. So it's got to put it somewhere so it doesn't poison your system. Your body will eat your own muscle. Your body will go through all of your minerals. Your body will go through every ounce of internal visceral fat, because you realize visceral fat, you guys, the fat that's inside your organs and brains and livers is where all the juicy minerals are, right? Do you think your body would want to eat your chubby arm fat or your heart fat? What's going to be more nutritious? So your body is going to survive even if it kills itself. So you will start getting bigger. Your muscle mass will decrease. Your vital organs will start to give out, especially the ones that, you know, we're like, oh, we didn't need that appendix anyways. Or, oh, that kidney stone, that's normal, runs in my family. It's like, this is not normal, okay? So migraines and bloating after every meal, because the body's like, I don't know what to do with this. Is it an enemy? Let's push everything out until we figure out. We're not used to having anything in the digestive tract because she's been starving herself. So now she ate a spoonful of peanut butter, and we got to blow everything out to see what this is so we can extract it, because it might be. It's almost like, I'm going to tell you guys, when you are in constant fight or flight, I like cartoons. is like when you're in constant fight or flight and your system is in constant overload with adrenalized shame, guilt, humiliation, fear, resentment, whatever, and you eat, it's like the bomb squad, like, boom, like everybody get away. Your body is so used to danger that it doesn't even trust what you're eating. So inflammation is a way to get your vital organs and everything away from what's in there. And like bomb squad comes in, immunity, and goes, what is that? And they're like, I think it's peanut butter. Well, last time we ate peanut butter, it had a preservative on it. Right. So now we've got to explode it. Right. So now I've got heartburn and there's all these like things happening and it's all because your body is trying to protect you. Doesn't know what the hell is going on because it's caught in a loop of overgrowth of sex hormones. Right. Oversexed, over hungry, under nurtured, undervalued. I'm not seen. I'm not heard. I'm not loved. I'm not safe. And the worst possible thing that happens from a woman's perspective in all of this is that it creates fertility issues or fibroids or cysts or cancers. And all along, all we've been doing is not responding to the 911 call because our job is to hold it together and keep the storm and the volcano quiet so that everyone else can feel nurtured. So you realize how much explosive energy goes in that. And this has nothing to do with, like, I've seen women who are estrogen dominant who are not overweight. Because again, weight will manifest differently from different genetic body types. So for me, you're going to see it right away on me. But someone who's naturally thin, you're going to see it in other places, like in inflammation. You're going to see them with back pain and migraines. You're going to see this energy explode differently, not necessarily manifest in a physical expression outside of the body, but constant pain and emergencies going on within the body because it is at this point no longer check engine. Engine's about to seize, but because the body survive. You could do this for 40 years. And that's the worst part of it. You know, it's like, it's bad enough being stuck in a body and then all this. So, whew. So yeah, there is your answer to your question. And of course you can see why I'm doing quantum fitness now, because there is no way that if we do not get to know what our body's doing to serve and protect us through our imbalances, then we can't blame the body and we can't blame genetics. We have to really look at the responsibility, respond to our lack of awareness of our own stress. So it's a good wake-up call, okay?